Morning, guys. It's Wednesday, June the 7th, 2023. And today is going to be a six count day, 20 minutes. I'm still debating, as of now, whether to do work with drop back down to 10 reps in the perimeter of a minute or stick with the 11s. I'm pretty worn out from 3 days of big effort. Obviously more than 3 days in a row, but the last 3 days I hit 240, 112 Navy SEALs, 246 counts, and then 112 Navy SEALs again. So those were three rather good days in a row. I'm feeling is all I should say, really. So let's see what today holds. I'm either wanting to go down to 10 and just taking it easy and cruising through and seeing how much time I can save, or sticking with the 11 at a relaxed pace, and again, seeing what I have. That one's going to be tough for some reason. That one rep. Let's hit the go button. I'm going to let the set decide. We'll see how it goes. Here's what I figure, is that my body, the session itself, will know best how to proceed once I begin, and things will go from there. I'll know when I know. There, 15 seconds. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10,
two, three, four, five, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1. Three, four, five. three, four, five, ten. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 39. Tough. Heavy legs. And my breathing's thrown off two or three times by the presence of cigarette smoke in the air. Take a deep breath and took in a lungful. Sort of coughing a little bit. Tried to refrain and keep going, but it didn't work. T39's not a bad day. Stuck with the 11s. I didn't know I was going to stick with the 11s until the 11th rep of the first minute. My approach. Might do five. I just see three sets of five. Who knows? 5. Alright, I thought about doing, continue with some burpees, but wouldn't be a bad idea to, I was going to do squat burpees. It would not be a bad idea to give my legs some rest for tomorrow. As well as my shoulders. Not counting rest periods. Here, I'll just go when I go. So with the 11s, I've been averaging in the high 230s. I had about 46 seconds. I had about a minute 46 seconds. I'm counting that 46 seconds as a rest extra rep period. And then the last minute is whatever I can spread out. So I got 6 reps in that rest period, in that 46 to 50 second rest period. I got about 6 reps. And then I sprinted out 11 at the end. Not a fast sprint, but it was still a sprint. After 19 plus minutes in, everything feels like a sprint. All right, 2 sets in, I got 1 more set to go. 3 sets of 5. Lots of rest. All right, 1 more set. I'm done for the day. I'm done burpees for the day. I still have a walk run left to do, as well as my second round of yoga in the afternoon before I meditate. Before I meditate, I will do another round of yoga. Mostly in the morning, I do my sun salutation and mostly seated postures. In the afternoon, I will do my meditation. Before I meditate, I'll do my round of sun salutation, followed by mostly standing asanas. I'll do sun salutation, and I'll do the warrior series, and then I'll do stuff like standing bow. Tree poses, stuff of that nature, balance poses. This is it, guys. Thank you. max of 2 reps. I found myself thinking this morning of the nature of love, unconditional love to be exact. It seems that we often confuse the nature of love with affection, with qualities, admiration, and things we like. If we were to say, why do we love someone? Most often, we would list attributes. I love how she's a great mother. I love how, just in my example, for a wife or even an ex-wife, in my case, I got some chalk on my lip. So I would name attributes, you know. I love her because she's a great mother. I love her things that she does for me, that she takes care of, little things that I forget to think about. It reminds me of things. All those, again, are attributes, and they have absolutely nothing to do with love. One of the best descriptions of love, as much as it can ever be described, love is the Tao. Same thing. So to say that we can talk of love is as abstract as trying to talk about the Tao, you know, as the Tao begins, that the true Tao that can be told is not the true Tao. And it's the same with love, but the closest that I've seen is St. Paul in his letters to the Corinthians, when he talks about the all-encompassing embrace of love. Love holds everything without discrimination. And that's why we fear love so much, true love, because that means everything is included, everything is accepted, even the things that we despise and the things that we hate. That is the nature of true love. It's the nature that Jesus talks about in the Sermon on the Mount. It's the nature that St. Paul talks about in his letters. It is the nature of forgiveness that Mark Twain mentions when he says, forgiveness is the fragrance released by the violet upon the heel that has stepped upon it. So think about that. The heel that has stepped upon the violet and the fragrance that's released from that violet, that's the essence of love. That doesn't mean that we accept everything blindly, saying that we accept abuse because it's the nature of love. No. That means that those are conditions within love itself. And in order to know love's presence ever more keenly, we notice those things that we don't like. And we notice as well that our desire to change them is as all-encompassing as love itself. That's the nature of love. So I know people say, well, the acceptance of starving children around the world, that can't be in love. Well, there's nothing absent from love. Love is ever present. It's all there is. It's the creation of the universe. So, of course, starving children are embraced within that. But my desire, your desire, to end that starvation, to end it immediately, that's the force of love. That's what we use to bring about change. That's the force that Gandhi harnessed to fell the British Empire. That's the lesson from the cross, that it's through love that we are resurrected. You know, as it says in the Course of Miracles, that the only lesson of the cross
is that we can all survive our own crucifixion. And not just survive, but we're reborn. There's a rebirth in coming from that. We are better served. So if someone, were to ask me, what is the nature of love? I could only shrug and say it's a mystery, and yet everything's included. Again, that's the unconditional nature. We always like to talk about, I have unconditional love, but it goes back to the Meatloaf song, but I won't do that. Well, unconditional love, except for this, except for that. Those are conditions, and unconditional love is the absence of any condition. When we know that, then it sort of becomes easier. A better word than accepting is realizing. That we realize that these things take place, and that we realize that we are that force of love, the only force of love that is capable of changing it. We're the only force capable of bringing about greater peace in the world, of ending starvation, of ending the homeless epidemic, of embracing those least among us. That's our role. We are to act within that unconditional embrace, the unconditional nature of love. So everything's occurring in love, and that means burpees as well. I don't have to like a rep. I don't have to like a session, but all of it's performed in love. It's just why I'm compelled to do them, for whatever reason. It's why they're here. It's why I hit the floor. It's why I come back up. It's why I hit the floor again. We can actually think of gravity as a force of love. It's that attraction that pulls us to the earth, that pulls us to the floor. It allows us to get back up, and it pulls us back down again. Everything occurring within that infinite embrace of unconditional love. All right, guys, sort of a rambling talk. Most of them are. I guess anyone who watches knows that by now. I will see everyone tomorrow. You have a good day.